Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today we're going to be covering another 5 scripts that I use daily. So 5 scripts that I really cannot live without, and they are my default daily workflow. But the scene that we're going to be using to demonstrate all those scripts is of course made by Evermotion, and this is Arc Interiors Volume 58 for Corona, and it's a pack of kitchens, and all these kitchens look absolutely amazing. It's all high quality models. But the scene that I'm going to be using today is this one, so this will be my victim. So let's jump into the scripts. So the first script that I'm going to be showing is Isolation Levels. So what is isolation levels? You know, when you hit Alt Q and you go into isolation mode, and you can practically just do that. So Alt Q and then go out of the isolation, and that's it. Well, this script can make you have multiple isolation levels. That's why it's called isolation levels. So let me show you how it works. So when you install it, you get this nice little toolbar here. These two arrows, new ISO, exit ISO. So how it works, look at this. If I wanna, let's say, select this, new ISO, right? Select this, new ISO again. This one, new ISO. Now take a look at this. You can go back with your isolation levels. So what I actually did, I've bound the isolation levels script to my shortcuts. So new ISO is Alt Q. To go back, I bound it to Alt A. So look how that works in practice. So let's say I want to select this. I just hit Alt Q, then select this, Alt Q, this, Alt Q, this, Alt Q, and then just Alt A. And that's it. I truly, truly love this script. Our next script that I'm going to be covering is SME SearchBar. So SME SearchBar is literally Material Editor SearchBar. So what I did with this script is I've bound it to my tab shortcut. So take a look at this. I just hit tab, you get this little thingy. Run a legacy, enter. Boom. Hit it again. Color, Corona color. Boom. You need color correction? Correct. Enter. And that's it. This is absolutely fantastic. I have no idea why this isn't a default thing in Max. It works flawlessly. It's awesome. So make sure to check it out. And our next script is a super easy script. It's called Turn to Instance, or Convert Unique Objects to Instances plugin. I said Turn to Instance because the file is called like that. And when you have a button in Max, it's called Turn to Instance. So what it does, when you clone your objects, right, and you want to clone them as an instance, but you forgot and you cloned them as a copy, you can actually select them all and just turn them to instances, and that's practically it. So in our beautiful Evermotion scene, let's say I want to clone this object, I don't know, let's say 3 times, right, and I forgot to clone these as instances. Well, what you can do, you can just select all 4 of them. Here I have Turn to Instance button, you click on it, and that's practically it. Look, all of these are instances now. Another cool thing is, if you, let's say, copy this again, and you toss an edit poly modifier onto it, and let's say we want to move this thing, right? So what you can do again is select all of them, turn to instance, just choose your source object where you want your instance to start. When you click it, these will become instances, but this object, because it has edit poly, will become a reference. So when I go here and I want to select these, it will be all applied. So yeah, this is a super, super handy script. Highly recommend you check this one out. Now our next script is my absolute must have. I'm really not sure if this is a script. I think this is more of a plugin, but I think it's worth mentioning. It's called FilePathFiner Pro. So FilePathFiner Pro is generally a plugin or a script that is going to link and manage all your links in your scene. And you can like easily access multiple parts of your scene through your textures. You can edit them in Photoshop. It will all be linked. Check this out. So I just drag and drop these props into my scene. And as you can see, they don't have any textures or anything. Look how easy it is to link everything. So File Pathfinder, you click it here and you get this. So all these textures, as you can see, this is an HDRI, which is loaded in properly and it has a gray background. But all the ones in this orangey color are the textures, as you see here, are missing. So what do you do? Well, you just need to roughly set up a search path of where your textures are. You don't need to go to a specific folder. So I know that all these textures are in my global RenderRam folder. So here I have all my videos and everything. So it's a mess. There's like hundreds of folders there. Take a look at this. When you click start, it will start to search this whole folder and all the folders that I defined there. And in literally a couple of seconds, all textures properly linked. As you can see here, all the textures are now there. Now, obviously this script costs us some money, but I think it's actually worth it. And let me show you why. So not only that you can find scripts, you can collect them. Here you can define like where is your textures folder, like project textures folder. And you can collect all those textures into that one folder just just with one click. The other cool thing is, if you have duplicate textures here, so literally two textures loaded at once, it will recognize them and merge them into one texture. Another cool thing, you can actually change these views, and now you can actually see what the textures are, where they are, where do they belong. So for example, if you select this one, you can go right click, select objects, and it will select an object where this texture actually belongs. You can do other multiple things like show map in viewport, disable map in viewports, etc. You can manually move stuff, copy to a different location, rename links, etc. There is this also one cool thing is you have the Photoshop button. So check this out. If you have this texture, you click on the Photoshop button, your Photoshop opens up, and let's say you want to modify the texture to something like this, right? And you save it as, let's say, version 1. Hit enter. Okay, you go back to your file path finder, right click, rename the link, and you just type 1 here, and it will instantly reload that texture and reload it in your whole max file. How many times have you imported tons of props in your scene? And you know, some props are super far away, you know, the textures of those props are like 8,000 pixels or something like that. Well, File Pathfinder has you covered. So you can select all of your textures here, let's say this, right click, and you have convert images. When you click that, you can convert all those images to a specified resolution. So what it will do, it will create a duplicate folder, and let's say if your desired maximum resolution on width is 2000 pixels, it will convert all the textures to a maximum of 2000 pixels. Of course, textures that are smaller than 2000 pixels will stay untouched. So take a look at this. If this is my 2000 pixel size, you click on start button here and it will start to load. Now what you will see that all these textures here that are right now being processed are turned into a 2K version. So you see the 2K everywhere. So that's it. So you can generally kind of optimize your scenes with File Pathfinder by reducing the unnecessarily large resolutions, etc. Also, as you can see on the webpage, it will show ES lights, it's going to show HDRI images and everything. And you can just, you know, select the texture. You can check which material that is in Material Editor. So it's a really, really handy tool to use. And this leads us to our final script, which is called Prune Scene. Why it leads us there? Because Prune Scene is a scene cleaner, antivirus, and all-in-one kind of thing. So what would happen a lot is whenever I would import, you know, multiple 3D Sky props, etc., in generally files from all different kinds of users, I noticed that my scene would start to be sluggish and slow, and save times would be abnormally large, just closing of max would be a nightmare, and this literally solved all my issues. So I have my Prune Scene button here, so this opens up. Here, you just generally press this start button and it will start cleaning all these things. One thing that I don't like this to clean is animation keys, but everything else, if there are like empty layers, missing objects, missing bitmaps, just garbage, memory cloggings or whatever, this will clean it up. It also has an antivirus protection, so it's like an active antivirus protection. I know Max has built-in antivirus protection, but there has been some reports where Prune Scene cleaned some viruses that Max's default protection didn't, so I don't know. Anyhow, how it works, you just click your start button here and that's it. It will tell you what it cleared. It even had some missing plugins. So yeah, now if I want to go and, for example, save this scene, take a look how much time it will take to save. So just take a look at here. So Control S, saving, done. And that's it. Closing max, hit X, done. And that's Prune Scene. I literally, like, every object that I get in my scene or my older scenes or whatever, I always Prune Scene check them. I always get a much snappier and much faster max. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to check these scripts out if you like them. Evermotion, thank you for sponsoring this video, and see you in next video. Bye.